the run across New Hampshire, 2010. It's 26 degrees at 5:25 a.m. and it's snowing on Mount Sunapee, and we're about 126 miles to the finish. So here we go. It's I don't know, 7:15, and I'm already lost. The greenway is not marked well. The Sunapee Ragged Kearsarge greenway, and it's especially not marked well on these town roads. And I don't even know if I'm on the right road right now. The good news is that the sun is up. It's a beautiful, clear morning after hiking in the snow this morning. And the foliage is just beautiful out here. So, as frustrated as I am already, it's hard to not be thrilled to be out here. Beautiful day. So the girls picked me up and brought me back to where I was supposed to go. So, needless to say, I've already added 3 miles to this adventure. So, if I make it to Monadnock, I'll have run 131.8 miles, as if 128 wasn't long enough. But that's the way it goes. And true to ultra fashion, I returned to the course from where I left or was supposed to go. So yeah. I don't think I cheated, but just frustrating to start the day. So, but sun continues to rise, and we're still running. So come out of your cave. This is a Bly Hill Cemetery, and up in that tree up there, there's a hawk, or an owl. I think it might be an owl. Yeah, it definitely is an owl. You guys can probably barely see him there on the left branch. Is a little white dot. And the trail here is right outside this house off of that road. And there's no markings to indicate that I needed to come up here. In fact, I asked a local homeowner at 7:30 in the morning, and about 100 yards off the trail, there's finally a blaze. So this is my chore. Trying to find a way is going to be the hardest part. Never mind running 130 miles. Just trying to figure out where this thing goes, I think. It's going to be the hardest part. So we're in the woods finally.
Rubs his back and strokes his hair, telling him it's okay to cry, but he just sits and stares. The merciless moon outside has nothing now he's come to realize. Only the desolation he feels, the cold distance inside. It's you and I now.
So, I'm not sure what mile I'm at, but I want to say I'm in the 20s, and I ran into my first hunters for the day. Looks like a father and son. They're bow hunting for deer. Kind of scary. I actually didn't see them until I was pretty much 15 feet away from them there. Camouflage so well. And the only reason I saw them is because they said hello. When they said hello, I almost jumped out of my skin. And it was just a friendly reminder that they are out here, and I'm glad I'm wearing bright colors. So, and if they're not hunting for deer out here, then they're hunting for maple syrup. And here's some of the lines coming out of the tree. And it attaches to a couple more lines, to more lines. It's just a big web of maple syrup. There I am, middle of the woods, and this is pretty much a theme for the day, are these rock walls built in the late 18th century, 19th century. And the farmers would plow their fields and have their ox drag every rock they found to the edge of their property and make these rock walls. But if you just think for a moment, all these trees, you can see how young some of these saplings are. This was all cultivated farmland at one point. And New Hampshire was all but 30% forested at one point. So, it's a little bit of history. It's you and I now, we can be alright. It's a major highway that goes through Vermont. You and I now, though it's cold inside, feel the tide turning. You and I now, we can be alright.
Look up on the world tonight with our blue diamonds that were once our fears pressing down on the Thames. We go out, my love, holding our lives.
I think it's about noontime. Climbing up Kearsarge. I got Josh with me. He's somewhere behind me. Both sucking wind. Since the last aid station, it's been about, I don't know, to the top of this mountain, it's like 5 miles uphill. So this is the longest climb of the whole expedition. And I'm feeling all right. But I was definitely putting this whole thing into perspective, and I know that if I can do this, this is going to be the hardest thing I've ever done, no doubt. I'm feeling pretty good. My hamstrings are a little tight from all the climbing, but after this peak, we're going to get some lunch and I'm going to share some of these views up here, but otherwise,
oh my lady, you're the woman I search to roll my heart this way, hey, cause I found you now, and forever I won't. Never I won't wait. This
Ragged Mountain ski area. This is the last major peak of the Sunapee Kearsarge Ragged Greenway is Mount Cardigan in the distance. Over this pine tree on the left is Mount Lafayette and Franconia Ridge. And then out there in the distance over the ski area sign is Mount Washington with a snow cap. So, we got about 25 miles to go from here to get back to Mount Sunapee. I hope to be there by midnight at the latest. It's about 4:30 in the afternoon now. So, 7.5 hours to do a marathon. Kearsarge and Ragged are running right after each other. I had a good 6 mile stretch where I was in the weeds, and so hopefully I can come back from the dead here and give it hell. It's, the sun's going down, it's getting cold again. But hey, it's all about potential, right?
Thanks. Feels like 8 millimeters.
So, I'm out here with Grant, and him and Josh have been taking turns running sections with me. We're about 47 miles into this thing, finally. It's 9 o'clock at night, and this has been a lot tougher than I thought. So, the goal's been changed. We're gonna go to Sunapee and go up and down, and then we're gonna drive down and climb Mount Monadnock with everybody. So, as that's the goal, is to do something that's never been done, and nobody's ever done the SKRG in one journey. So we'll have accomplished that, and we just wanted to get people outside with us and learning about the conservation of these lands, and I wanted to climb Mount Monadnock finally, so we're going to do that, and that's where we are. So we're going to keep moving, and probably about 10 hours for 30 miles from here, so it's we're just going to keep going.